They said it cannot be done, but Xanatec finally done it.
What you guys are about to say. In no way I am a gaming enthusiast. I just love tech, you know, PCs, tablets, phones, whatever. But hey, it's 2020, guys, so new year, new computer. Well, sort of, but it's not really new. But it's time for me to upgrade my PC. In today's video, I'm going to show you what are the compatible upgrades for a Dell Optiplex 990 mid tower, and hopefully we can upgrade it to make it work in today's standards. You guys wanna play Apex Legends, PUBG, Fortnite, but your PC is just not up for it? Well, stay tuned. So all the stuff that I'm gonna be using in this video, I'll be leaving a link on the description below for you guys to check it out. If you happen to have the same system as I do, and hopefully this video will help. All right, a little overview with my system. The Optiplex 990MT came stock with an Intel i5 2400 processor, which is a quad core processor running at 3 GHz. So the max RAM for this system is 16 GB of RAM. So that's hefty enough for me to be able to multitask, do video editing, and at the same time, do a little casual gaming with this system. So I'm pretty much covered with that. And then I also have a terabyte of hard drive. So it's a mechanical hard drive, so we're gonna have to upgrade that with an SSD. So I'm gonna show it to you later on in this video. I've seen some other videos on YouTube that they're trying to upgrade their same system. So I went to PCBuild.com. Is that what it's called? I'll leave the link in the description below. They're using an NVIDIA GTX 1050 Ti OC, which is overclocked and at 4 GB of VRAM. I'll be showing you some clips later on. It can actually run Fortnite, PUBG, and Apex Legends with no problem. First off, we're gonna be upgrading the power supply, because the power supply that came in stock with the Dell Optiplex, it's really low. And in order for you to use a graphics card with that caliber, like I said earlier, you're gonna need some good amount of power. This one is kind of like a budget build. I'm not gonna go way overboard because I know it's almost a decade old system. So I'm not gonna spend like $80, $90 for 1000 watt power supply. So I was able to find a Corsair 450M. So this is like 450 watts. M stands for modular, and I'll leave the product link in the description below. I like this because it's modular, so you don't have a bunch of wires dangling around, so you can have like a cleaner build or a cleaner upgrade. So that's the very first one that I have to upgrade in my computer. So I pull out the old PSU and slap in that 450M, and it fits perfectly for my system. Moving on to the graphics card, I chose the Gigabyte GTX 1050 Ti OC edition with 4 GB of video RAM. And this one, I grabbed the G1 edition where you can actually overclock it, but I'm not gonna do that. Like I said again, I don't do a lot of gaming. I do a little bit of casual gaming, but for video purposes, so you guys can see the actual performance of this video card, I chose the G1 because of the fact that not only, I got 4 monitors, and all of this is running on that video card. It actually has 5, so it's got 3 HDMIs, 1 DisplayPort and 1 DVI port. So I'm using the 3 HDMIs and 1 DisplayPort, and it just looks great. I love it. It's like a command center in here. I had a little bit of trouble trying to slide it in there with the PCI Express slot, but nevertheless, I was able to fit it in there, and I think for me that was a success. I was able to upgrade it to a Windows 10, so I'm running Windows 10 now. So SSD is a lot faster. By like a lot, like in comparison with a mechanical hard drive, it's a lot faster boot up times and all that good stuff. So I used Macrium Reflect to clone my OS into the SSD, and it worked perfect. I'll solely be using it as a boot drive, so everything is just a lot snappier, and later on I can always upgrade. I got the 240 gig SSD from SanDisk. I'll also leave that link in the description below. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. So, you know, Like I said, I'm trying to move this almost decade-old PC into the future, which is 2020, like from what you saw in that intro. I don't know why I spent too much time on that intro. Please subscribe. So I bought some RGB lighting, and it actually looks really good, guys. And for some extra points for a cool factor, guys, I bought an acrylic sheet, and I was able to cut my side panel. So that side panel is totally optional, guys. But for YouTube's sake, I'm gonna show you how I did it anyway. Alright, so the main question, how much did I ended up spending with this build that I did? So I needed a really reliable power supply, so I bought it brand new, so that's about 60 bucks. And the SSD is about 50 bucks, and RGB lighting is about 15 bucks. However, the G1 model that I have, the GTX 1050 Ti that I have from Gigabyte, it's a hit or miss with the pricing, so I didn't buy it brand new, because it's well over in the 300s, and it's kind of ridiculous, really. However, I was able to find one. You can actually find one on eBay for about 100 bucks, which I paid 105 for mine, with 30-day returns. So if ever it fails, there's always that, you know, don't buy anything where it says no returns, because you're otherwise you're gonna have a lemon sitting here and you won't be able to use it. All in all, I spent about 230 bucks, and to me that's like a really budget build, and for what I intend to use it for video editing. I mean, I'm using DaVinci Resolve, and it's actually not even, it's hardly dropping any frames. Even if you put a 60 FPS video on the editing screen, and it actually does the job, no glitching, no dropped frames or anything like that. And that was the main purpose, actually, why I upgraded my system, so I can make more videos and save me some time and subscribe to my YouTube channel. New videos every time I upload. That's technically not a lie. So there you have it, guys. Thanks for watching. I appreciate the subscription, guys. For you guys been sticking out with me since day one, I really appreciate it. And make sure you hit that like button. And if you don't like this video, well, you know what to do. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.